This is Nasir Gazdar. Today we are going to explore the earthquake safety, and this video is being produced, directed by explorer Ronald. I, Nasir Gazdar, is narrating it, so that we have this theme of knowledge is safety. So this thing will cover both earthquake primary and secondary effects. So here we see that the earthquakes do create the ground shaking, but after an earthquake we can expect aftershock and secondary impacts like floods, landslides, ground shaking and tsunamis. Our main theme is, are we prepared? So what is an earthquake? Earthquake is the ground shaking, and this one causes a lot of damages because everything is on the ground. We humans cannot keep our balance. And this is a picture of how does the seismic activity happens. Seismic activity is kind of a mysterious thing, which is due to the friction between the rocks and the fault plane on which the friction and tension build up is a fault zone. And this extends for tens of kilometers within the earth crust. And then what happens after 100 years, the rocks yield to the friction and tension and they buckle up. When they deform, it causes the ground shaking. Now, all over the world, we have, these movement of the tectonic plates. Where the plates are colliding, these are where most of the earthquake activity happens. There are a lot of mysterious earthquakes that we cannot explain because they are within the boundary of, for example, Arabian plate, North American plate, and Eurasian plate. Now, these are the damages caused by the ground shaking, such as collapsed building in Turkey. So this earthquake happened a couple of months ago, and here we can see that the buildings are damaged because of the construction and the ground on which they have been built. And so seismic activity is very awesome. It is the greatest force from the earth's shaking. So again, remember, there are different kinds of earthquakes. This is a strike slip earthquake. This is not a tectonic one, but all of these causes the problems. The thing is that earthquakes can originate at various depths between the earth's surface, even hundreds of kilometers deep. But shallow earthquakes can be more destructive. So we need to learn more about the rocks and, their behavior. And that, the builders, study those to make the earthquake resistant building. So seismic waves travel faster through hard rock than through the softer rock or soil or beach sand. However, as the waves pass from harder to softer rock, they slow up and their strength increases. So shaking is more intense when ground is softer. Nevertheless, even buildings on hard ground can also experience intense shaking and damages if they are close to the surface plane or rupture. Now, this is the damages done to the structure. This is done by Italian geophysicist Mercalli. This is a Roman scale of 1 to 12. And of course, the impact of the earthquake is also, calculated because of this destruction. Earthquake energy is calculated from the modified Richter scale. Now, this is the Turkey. Here we have seen the railway track move 2 meters, about 6.6 feet in a frozen ground. So these are the primary and secondary effect. This is another impact of the earthquake in Turkey, where homes and infrastructure has been damaged. So how to prepare for earthquake before, during, and after? So of course, we will look at some of these things. that we have to make a family plan. We have to be informed immediately. So networking, communication is the key for the safety. And we have to have the emergency kit, and also we have to participate in Shakeout earthquake drill. So here again, remember, this is a, before the earthquakes, we should know about the earthquake area that we are situated on, and history repeats itself. So there are many steps. These are 7 steps before, during, and after. So of course, our aim is to be safe. So we have to get ready to shake out, and the main drill is about drop to the floor, take cover under a table or a hard surface, and hold on till the shaking stops. So this is a more elaborate graphic presentation. Drop on our knees and hands with our heads down. And so this is the thing that we have to crawl beneath a hard or sturdy desk or something very hard, and then we have to cover. Most of the earthquake injuries are on the head. Our head is softer, and then it cannot cushion. And so we have to cover our head and neck with one arm and hand. And a study table or desk is nearby, crawl underneath it for shelter. And if no shelter is there, then crawl next to an interior wall away from windows. Stay on our knees, bend over to protect vital organs. And then we have to hold on till the shaking stops. Under shelter, hold on to our shelter with one hand. Be ready to move if it is shifts. No shelter, hold on to our head and neck with both arms and head. Now this is the to build a kit. We have to have all these amenities at least for 7 to 10 days. From first aid to the tools to pet supplies and toilet paper to small bills, and so these things should be kept in a backpack or in a large bag, so that we can be safe. Now this is a little example that the ceiling fixture or the wall fixture may damage. And here is another pictorial that the damages can be caused by anything that is not anchored very well. And so that's why the earthquake safety and precaution must be practiced in a drill. So here the this is the emergency supplies, from water to flashlight to radio, and there are many other safety tips. And also we have to be prepared and aware and be ready where is our evacuation area. And so this is the important, because some buildings will get demolished. And so this is one survey that 73% of people do not know how to stay safe during an earthquake. And again, the people in earthquake risk area are taking more action to prepare. And that's why our drill will be done to perform this practice. And this thing is that the awareness in community is very important. Without the knowledge of safety, we cannot achieve the earthquake safety. And preparedness action should be done in an emergency drill. And this is again the key influences to earthquake preparation. We have to be aware of the information. We have to have some stories from the survivor. We have to be having efficiency, and then we have to have the that the risk perception is important. 99% of the people acknowledge that the occurrence of at least one disaster type could impact where they live. So again, remember, knowledge check. At which plate boundaries are earthquake occur? This is, you know, important because if we are on a boundary where friction and tension are building up, then, you know, we have to be very, very careful. And of course, most of the earthquakes can occur along divergent, convergent, and plate transform boundary. A very large earthquake may trigger other intraplate fender benders earthquake. And there are mysterious or phantom earthquake. All of these things can, you know, make our disaster preparedness more, you know, tune up. So are we prepared? Yes, we are prepared. If we are not prepared, then we will have, you know, problem. Now here is, you know, this cartoon that if we are not prepared, then we will be gasping for, you know, our breath and, you know, problem. So please do explore the earthquake safety from your local area. And thank you for watching this video.